Hello everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Monsters channel. Yeah, today let's do something really cool. Because I showed you this video, 100 days, it's basically my new track. Well, the thing about it that's most special to me is actually the way the melody sounds. The leads, the layering, the mixing, because I've been looking for that for a long time. And exactly, precisely 100 days ago, I started this mission of pure dedication, finding out how it's been done. So that's really funny because the first three notes of the melody, I based them on an old Stargate SG-1 episode, which had a really nice soundtrack. It's a really good episode, by the way. And guess what? It's called 100 Days. So I figured I wanted to call it Waiting, but I liked the title. And then I discovered it was precisely 100 days ago since I started this mission of finding out how the big guys do it. Yeah, so the title was solid. It's going to be called 100 Days. Well, the reason I haven't finished it yet and the reason you didn't hear my kick yet was because my kick is not finished yet. I'm trying to create a kick that sort of honors the track. And it's hard, but I'm getting there. So today let's make a melody. Let's make a hardstyle melody. And let's show you how I made this really smooth sound. So, the melody we are going to use for this tutorial, we are not going to create a new one. We are sort of going to reinvent one. Because we are going to make some sort of Headhunter Soundrush style melody, perhaps a bit wild styles. But in hardstyle, like Breakaway by Soundrush, that's the Relevation song, they sometimes reuse other songs. And turn it into a hardstyle melody. And yeah, that's what we are going to do. I'm going to use Hallelujah. So let's go. First, let's start the same way I started with the 100 Days melody. I'm going to grab Kontakt. You don't need Kontakt for this, but I suggest you find some sort of piano. Fruity Loops has some really, Fruity Loops. Can't call it Fruity Loops because they got sued by Fruit Loops, you know, the cereal. So FL Studio has some nice pianos too. Of course, I'm not talking about FL keys. I don't even know why they invented that. I think it's this one. Okay, let's name it. Let's keep it Kontakt 5. Perhaps we'll keep it, perhaps not. But for now, it's just the melody sketching thing. I'm going to use for Hell Room. I think I used Dark Chamber. And let's turn the reverb down a bit, depth all the way up. So, to keep this tutorial a bit shorter than usual, I'm not going to talk about my keyboard. I'm saying this because I wanted to talk about my keyboard. Well, Hallelujah. So, let's try to remember how it went. Oh, wow, damn, that's the right note. Well, this is also the right note. Depends on what kind of transposing skill, whatever you use. I'm enabling the metronome, and when you do right click, you can even select a different type of sound. And why would you want to use a cowbell, really? I think the cowbell, that's one of the old hypes from when your parents were young or something. Da, 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 da. All right. So the melody starts here. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The melody basically starts where the kick starts playing. So that's over here. This is basically the pre-melody or the staircase. Or whatever. Let's keep this as basic as possible because all the difficult stuff is going to happen later. Alright. Now we got this. This is basically it. This is the start of your melody. just ping a little bit, I don't know, make something up. Now, the second important thing, you need a melody, but you also need a bass line, and the bass line has to fit. So I'm not really sure if this is the right bass line, but I'm pretty sure the rhythm goes like this. Okay, that's it, everyone. So thank you all for what... No, just kidding. Well, I just realized this is not going to be a short tutorial, but hey, this is valuable stuff, people. Worked really hard for it. Just sit down, relax, enjoy, and have a beer. Now let's copy the bass line, throw it in here. And let's do this. So now the melody starts at the right place. Just remember, this is coming before the melody starts. So let's make a bass. Yeah, that's the right point. Okay, so I'm thinking about adding a second part, but we can do that later. Okay, so let's call this one main lead. I'm actually trying to remember the routing I did in the previous video, the 100 days track, because I sort of did stuff a little bit different. And sometimes, you know, that's the key. When you're trying to achieve this thing and you try for a really long time and it just doesn't work, perhaps you should change your strategy. And that's what I did, and it worked. So, within exactly 100 days, I still think the universe is fucking with us. But hell, it's interesting. So, keep fucking. Now we need to make this melody interesting. So let's not go to 1/6 beat. Let's go to 1/3 step. So this is really important. Go to 1/3 step instead of 1/6 beat. 1/6 beat is easier. Well, in a way, 1/3 beat might be the best way. But we want to go to 1/6 beat because we want to go to 1/3 step. Because this is really important to make the melody perfect. So this is where the 1/3 step gets confusing. Step 1, get your MIDI right, your melody and your bass line. Step 2, get your rhythm right. The rhythm, I mean the note lengths. Don't go all autism or Asperger on this. Just try to work with your feeling. Try to listen instead of looking. Well, looking is important, but try to listen. Try to feel it. Should this note be longer or shorter? I did the same thing with the 100 days track. It needs to have some sort of swing. So grab something like this. Yeah. So it doesn't really matter how long or how short the notes are. When you work with your feeling, just sort of make sure it's not totally random. It does need to work. There does need to be... It's nice to have a little structure in there. Okay, let's check it again right now. And from there it continues right here. So now perhaps it's time to turn off your mind. Hardwood style. Crap, it's catchy. Okay, let's select a lead. Now, I really suggest I can show you in this tutorial how to make your own leads, but I'm saving that for another tutorial, because when you are in the creative flow, you don't want to go all technical, really. So make sure you have a nice preset bank you can instantly use. I actually replaced the Factory 1 bank from Silent 1 with my own sample bank, so I can instantly click this. When I open Silent 1, I have the inert sound, and I can instantly browse through my own sounds. Yeah, if you want to check it out, if you haven't checked it out yet, check the description. But if you already have another bank which works great for you, sure, use that. Replace the Factory 1 bank, and this might really improve your workflow. Unless you really love that Silent 1 ARP sound when you open it up. Let's decide what kind of melody this is going to be. That's going to be our main lead. Well, I think square leads are a bit overused, but for this type of lead, it's a bit emotional. Let's still go for the square lead. That's this one. Alright, so let's go a bit longer. Like this. And let's add some gliding notes. So now we have a main lead sound. Let's decide where it glides and where it doesn't glide. Perhaps right here. Oh, I really like this one. Alright, so this is not a lot of gliding notes, but it does add something. Like the melody is, well, basically it's a lead, and the first lead in a song, that's mostly your vocal. So in a way we are trying to imitate a voice here. So yeah, it adds a little bit of imperfections of character, of trying to express a note you really can't express, but hell, you still make it, or I don't even know, but it adds something. Now let's make this main lead stronger. Yeah, so I'm going to hit the space bar and press enter like this, because I'm going to route all of them leads to the same bus. This helps me to keep track of everything. Let's select the favorite saw. And now, for this tutorial, we are going to make sure the monologato portamento knob is on the same level. It doesn't have to be perfect, but make sure they are a bit close to each other. Alright, really nice. So now let's grab a nice bass line. I prepared this one for this tutorial. Load, are you looking for me? Huh? Yeah, that's the one. I used this one in the 100 days video. Let's go way lower. Okay, so I like it when it goes up here, but I still think this one is too low. So we are going to transpose the entire melody. With 4 notes. Okay, crap. Messed something up again. Okay, main lead. So, like this. in a way, this might be a bit too high. Let's try if one octave down works for this melody. So in this case, two things are important. Make sure your bass line doesn't go too low. And you know, you can simply transpose this one up. Might make more sense, but for the vibe of the melody, it sounds better when it goes down. Because hallelujah, hallelujah, happy, sad, in a way. And over here it sort of resolves in a euphoric way. Now, next up, we are going to layer in mono. So yeah, let's continue by making the leads mono, making everything mono in fact. We can simply do this, and it will have the same result, but I want to make a switch for my workflow, and that's going to be Hercules Imager. Oh, crap, it's still called Split Torus here, sorry. Okay, so I'm removing the side circuit. So now it's mono, and I can simply activate or deactivate it. Now the reason I'm making everything mono right now when I'm layering my main lead is because your main lead should still sound stable when it's a mono. And trust me, when it sounds nice in mono, it sounds just better in stereo. Now I'm going to grab Late But Great. It's some sort of buzz lead, and it fits really well with these two leads. That's the thing I have learned after a million remakes and lots of unfinished songs. I now know what kind of leads go together. The square lead will sound bigger when you add the saw lead. And when you add the buzz lead, it'll give it more texture. And this is mono, people. When I turn it back to stereo, it'll sound really great. So let's try to add one more lead to make it as strong as possible. Perhaps the tweaker style lead, or perhaps not. But I really want a Savannah. Okay, please tell me when you see it. Oh wait, doesn't work like that. I have to edit the video first. Okay, so here it is. Right. So these go together. Now here's another thing I want to do. We want to make a really smooth, euphoric, emotional melody. So let's make the leads a little bit less punchy. By opening the attack a little bit and the release a little bit to make it sound more smooth. Make sure all of your layers have the same setting of the leads and chords mostly. This should sound really smooth. Okay, so this is going to be a lot of editing because I'm already at 34 minutes. Well, not on YouTube, but in real time I am. Now it might be time to add some chords. So let's go mono again. So this is going to be chords. Or chords, if you prefer. Now, let's remove all the gliding notes because they don't really work with chords. And yeah, now we remove them. That's basically it. That's the nice thing about not having a lot of glide notes. Let's make this one match the bass line. Okay, so check this out. Okay, so we realize there are no bass notes here, but this is going to be the intro to the melody, so it doesn't really matter. This is going to be the intro to the second part of the melody, so there are bass notes there. Now, let's make chords. Right here, right now. I'm holding shift, I'm holding my left mouse button, releasing shift and basically dragging up. and again. So this will sound totally terrible. That's because we need to fix it. Alright, let's do it without playing. Right, that's going well. So don't worry if the chords aren't perfect at this moment. We are going to do harmonies for this song, and then it will really come out when there are some wrong notes. Alright, so maybe these chords are great. Alright, so by doing a chord inversion, because the main melody is now on the bottom, it might be nice to have it in the middle. We might hear some mistakes better. So let's control, arrow down, let's check it again. Perhaps we can now hear some mistakes. So there are some dissonant or detuned or whatever, some weird notes in here. And I know detunes will tell me, hey man, these notes are sounding really bad, blah 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 blah. But guess what? I don't give a shit. So yeah, you know, music reflects us as being human. It sort of separates us from being machines or robots. A whole paradox there, but you know, we are humans, we are not perfect, machines are. Machines are perfect as the person who programmed them or whatever. But when there's a wrong note, but it was put there with feeling, not with lack of concentration or interest, no, with feeling. That's what makes it nice. So don't focus on perfection, focus on feeling. That's what makes music good, you know? Because the most boring music in the world is perfect music. We don't want to have perfect music. We want to have something nice. Let's find a nice preset. Let's make sure it matches with the other leads. Okay, for this one. Okay, so let's start layering chords together. I'm going to use Spire for this too. Where's Spire? Really don't buy that many plugins. Oh, there it is. Okay, adding Spire. I'm going to do the same thing with the leads. I'm going to press space, give it no name because it's going to the same bus. Now, menu, Fruity Masters, filler. This is a really virus kind of sound in a way. And just hear what it does to your chords. So when I disable mono, this is how it sounds, with the chords. Okay, I think these chords are perfect. Let's stay in stereo for a while. Let's add another silent. And I recently started using these, this preset. I used it once, that's why it's in the bank, but I now start using it again. It's the noise controllers thing. I made this from the track Savannah when I did the really old remake with the very first preset bank. And it's really dirty and distorted, and it might add some dirt to the chords right here. So, by the way, don't worry if your chords are a little bit too much stereo, and when you go mono it sort of disappears. That's not a problem, because it's all about the main lead. And in our case, that's mostly mono. So let's check out our track so far. I didn't even check the balance, by the way. So this is how our melody sounds at the moment. So it's starting to sound really nice. Now the leads could use some dirt. Not the square. So let's go to the saw, pitch AB, give it a little bit of range, go to the noise, rate all the way up. Just hear what happens when I increase the gain. So this will make the melody a bit more dirty. Not sure if you can hear the difference, but it'll do something. And you know, a lot of tiny details, when you all throw them together, it's a big detail, you know. By the way, I switched to mono when playing this. It's completely stable at the moment. So that leaves us many options. I'll show that later. First, let's do some harmonies, and that's going to be easy. So with the harmonies, we are going to do... Is this the Fave saw? Okay, let's use the saw. Let's go up. Let's name this one Harmony 1. This one, 1, you know. And let's clone it again. Let's name it Harmony 2. And let's move it up here. Let's move the contact all the way down, because it's starting to annoy me. Now, let's clone the main lead over here. And let's try to do the first harmony. And now, this is really clear. When you have ghost notes enabled, you can do that here with helpers. And ghost channels. Just drag it up. And now it fits. And now the only thing you have to do is correct the wrong notes. Which is not a lot. And this is the first harmony, because it's the first second melody on top of the main. I'm not sure if this is how they call it in music theory, but I don't care. I'm learning you this. I'm teaching you my way. So, copying the main lead again, let's do the harmony 2. And in this case, we are going to go down. Doing the same thing. You know, I could skip this part with editing, but I realize a lot of people still don't get this thing. Just here to help you out, guys. So, oh wait. Let's transpose it all the way up, and let's go to the first harmony again. Clone it. And let's name it low. With this, we are going to add more depth. Or, look at this. Now it's way more heavy. Make sure the low harmony, it's basically the same thing as harmony 1, but it's low, so don't give too much volume. Now let's go to the mono again, let's enable it mono, and let's stabilize the volumes. And the second harmony. Yeah, nice. So I'm pretty sure this will sound really cool in stereo again. So this is how it sounds right now with the harmonies. Okay, but we want to have a really nice and smooth melody right here. So with that in mind, I think the harmonies are a bit too loud. So let's balance them again. It's the same thing when you start up GTA 5 for the first time. You need to balance the Rockstar logo so it's barely visible with your controller or your mouse or whatever. Same thing with the harmonies. You still need to hear them, but they shouldn't be in your face. They shouldn't be at front, they should be on the back, because that's the thing with harmonies. You have your lead singers in the middle, and your harmonies, your vocalists, your very pretty short skirt female singers or whatever in the back. That's how it should be. Harmonies are basically pieces of chords, of course. The main lead, that's what it's all about. So make sure your main lead pops out. That's important. Same with the bass line. It's a bass line. It needs to be steady. You don't want your house to collapse. You need to rise. You need a steady bass. So here we go again. Okay, so now we are going to add everything to the mixer. Holding control, and now with shift, only the ones with names get to enter the mixer. Ha! That's a bit of racism, maybe. Well, control L is now all on the mixer. Now we are going to route all of the unnamed layers to the same buses as the one above. Same with the chords. And now we have a really smooth mixer. Yay! So, first thing we're gonna do, let's make a bus called Leads. This is going to be called Leads. And now, Leads and Chords. Give it a nice other color. So, like this. So, all of the leads. Well, harmony 2, harmony 1 low. Let's throw the harmonies. I didn't really do this before. Or I didn't really do this in my other track, but perhaps we can improve it. Let's route all of the harmonies to leads and chords. And let's route the main lead to the leads. Does that make sense? No. Alright, so leads. Oh yeah, crap, no sound. Okay, let's disable the chords for now. And the harmony one low. Right, so these are the leads. Let's give it a nice low cut. And now I realize I'm clipping, so let's just fix that the lazy way by... yeah, okay, fuck it. So I'm now going to add compression. CLA-3A stereo. What the CLA-3A does, it's basically a preset compressor based on a really old compressor, which used to be really expensive, and now it isn't anymore because it's software, which does the same thing in a way. It merges the sounds together a bit, and it gives it a nice attack. This is also the same compressor the Tweakers use for their punchiness in the leads. Yeah, so basically that. You can do this with the Fruity compressor. I actually remade this setting and I tweaked it a little bit. You can download that for free. Look in the description. There's this free melody link or whatever. I'm not sure with stock plugins. I don't know which one it is. So what about the chords? Let's enable this one and do it this way. That's stereo. That's mono. So let's make it more stereo. It's way too stable. Nice. Same with the leads. Alright, something like that. Now let's check out our melody, how it sounds right now. And after that, let's do some fancy reverb, ARP, organ, stuff. So up next, the next things we are going to do to finish up this tutorial, we are going to add an organ, we are going to add an arp, reverb and delay, and it's all going to be sidechained. So now let's make an organ. We're not going mono anymore. Right, so for the organ, same thing with 100 Days, I used Lush, it's by Drummerzone, and hey, check it out right now, because they have this really cool sale, with Black Friday and stuff. Also, by the way, I might be able, I might be doing a Black Friday discount myself, not because I care, just because I think it's funny. Now, Megatron, what the hell is that? Ooh, that's a nice lead. Organ. I think I use this one, but it sounds good enough anyway. So let's go to the next pattern and let's match these chords. Okay, and well, we basically copied the chords here with the organ, but this might be nice to give the organ a little bit of credit. Let's transpose the bottom note, that's basically harmony 2, and let's do this. Okay, this will do a lot, people. Let's name this one organ. And now let's do the arp. Silent one. Arp. What? Arp. Okay. This one can go. Again. For the arp, I have a really nice preset in my bank again. It's called Arped. Disable the delay and reverb and the arp. Well, keep the delay and the reverb, just disable the arp now and follow your organ chords. Alright, so let's throw these ones in the mixer too. Let's check out the mixer. Anything happening here? Baseline. Well, arp and organ. So we are going to sidechain the organ, at least, with the leads and chords. So for that, this is important because, well, let's show you. Well, this is basically a little bit of ranking. The first choice, the most important person here, that's the main lead. And after that, the chords and the harmonies and the organ basically is a filler. It's some sort of different kind of reverb in a way. So we need to sidechain this. And now I have a really nice sidechain plugin for that, and that's called Track Spacer. If you have the money and you know what it does, you understand it, check it out, it's really worth it. But you don't need it, but it's really nice. Yeah, it basically sidechains, but it doesn't really just do that. It sidechains only on the frequencies you give it. So that's really special. I don't know how they did this. And maybe I don't want to know. I just like it. So leads and chords go to organ, sidechain. Let's disable everything else. We want to hear the effect. Now, thank the Lord for FL Studio, because we need to do some other stuff before it works. Simply click here on the gear logo, go to the second tab, processing, sidechain 1. So, nope. Now it works, but it's way too extreme, and we don't want the high cut. We don't want to sidechain the extreme highs, maybe. You don't really want to hear the sidechain, you want to feel it. So that's it for the organ. For the arp, let's see if it needs more reverb. Well, wait. So for now, our dry melody is all set to go. So now let's add in some reverb. It's called Perfection Reverb. And perfection delay. Let's disable everything else again and route this one to the reverb. It's basically for Valhalla Room with this setting. You can copy it if you want, and Fruity Limiter with this setting. It's not really that special. I disabled this EQ and I even forgot to remove it. But yeah, it works. So, it's a perfect reverb. I'm not going to change anything because I don't hear big mistakes. Let's throw this one to the delay. Let's just check it out. How does it sound right now? So, before I show you the end result, let's add it to the playlist right here. And let's add it again. And remove this part, remove, whatever. And right here, so. This should do it. So, this is our end result. Thank you all for watching this incredibly long tutorial, because right here it says it's at 1 hour and 11 minutes. Now, when you look at the YouTube tutorial, you know it isn't that long. So, a little credit for the editing. Now, if you want to have sounds like these, leads like these, presets, whatever, for Silent One, Serum Spire, check out my producer bundle. Or, well, basically the producer bundle is everything combined together. Or the solo bundles like the Silent One Preset Bank, the Serum Bank, the sample pack. It's really good stuff and it's really cheap. And yeah, if you haven't checked it out yet, this might really help you out with your flow, with your stuff. Don't bother using my kicks in the pack, you know, that's why it's a pack. So, yeah, perhaps this helps you out, because hardstyle isn't the most easy genre to work with, to work in, to learn. It might be one of the most difficult genres, actually. Well, dubstep is a bitch too, but yeah, so, don't forget to check it out, it's all in the description. This is our end result for today. Thanks all for watching, see you again next time.